I knew from early on that I wanted to be involved with aviation. So I learned science, I learned technology, so that I knew how airplanes operated and the physics behind those, and I built remote control airplanes as a kid. I basically, in college, minored in drones, which means I learned how to fly drones, I learned how to collect data with drones, and I learned how to adapt that to different business needs, such as agriculture.
Start looking at why you think drone technology is really cool, and then start looking at how your education ties to that. What courses are going to make you more effective?
No matter what we do in the drone industry, whether it's the actual plane itself, the drone itself, or the data that we're collecting and building algorithms on that data, it all has those base fundamentals of science and math.
A lot of people get turned away from STEM topics because maybe they think they don't like math, or maybe they had a bad experience with the science class.
I often found myself asking, what am I going to use this for? And now it makes sense. Everything we do with the drones, they have to know where they're at. So geometry is directly applied, and algebra is directly applied. So there are real world things and amazing technologies that, while we're learning these in sixth and seventh and eighth grade and all the way through high school, that they really do have real world application.
We're going to see UAS technology integrated across a lot of different educational programs. There's been a lot of excitement, a lot of major accomplishments, as we're literally breaking ground on new developments on a daily basis. Northland Community and Technical College launched the first UAS maintenance training program. We currently offer summer camps that really cover a wide array of educational disciplines. They get to learn about the electronic systems that drive the stability, allow the system to perform flight, and beginning the discussion about where they might like to use those systems in the future. So as you look at technology, there's so much uncertainty of where it's going to go tomorrow. What really makes a good student is curiosity, a passion to look at what's possible today, but imagine what they could do tomorrow.